Hello everyone, welcome to GATE Education. This question is from mathematics. The question says that consider the two-dimensional vector field F which is equals to xi plus yj, where I and j denote the unit vectors along the x-axis and y-axis respectively, and a contour C in the xy plane is shown in the figure. So a contour in the xy plane as shown in the figure is composed of two horizontal lines. These are the two horizontal lines, one is this and second one is this, connected at the two ends of by two semicircle arcs of the unit circle. So these are the two semicircle arcs. So with the help of these two lines and two semicircle, this is the closed contour that is made, and the contour is traversed in the counterclockwise direction. So contour is in the counterclockwise direction, in this direction. So that is, this is the counterclockwise direction. What we have to find? The value of the closed path integral, that is f dot dx I plus dy j, right? So now we will put the value of f here. So this becomes closed contour integral. The value of f is x I plus y j dot dx I plus dy j. So this is the dot product. We will multiply x component and we will multiply y component separately. So this will equals to closed contour integral x dx plus y dy, right? Now you know the Green's theorem. This is the form of Green's theorem. Let us say that this is the value of m and this is the value of n. So what Green's theorem says that any closed contour line integral will be converted to a surface integral like this. That is del n over del x minus del m over del y into differential surface area. So this is the xy plane. So what will be differential surface area in the xy plane? That is dx into dy. Now we will solve this surface integral by putting the value of n and m. Let us do that. The surface integral will be equals to, what is the value of n? The value of n is y here, that is del y over del x, minus the value of m is x. So this is del x over del y into dx into dy. So now we can clearly see that we are differentiating this first with respect to x, but y is constant with respect to s. So this differentiation is zero, and we differentiating with respect to y this value x. So the x will be treated as constant with respect to y. So this differential is also zero. So the answer for this question is nothing but the surface integral, that is the first differentiation is zero, that is del m over del x is equal to zero. Similarly, del x over del y, that is del n over del y is also zero, into the differential surface area, that is dx into dy. So the answer for this question is, this is zero, overall answer is zero. So we are getting the answer for this question zero, right? So this is the one method we followed of the Green's theorem, right? Now we can solve this question by using another method, which is known as Stokes theorem. What Stokes theorem says that any closed contour integral, that is f vector dot dl vector, will be equals to surface integral of curl of f vector dot ds vector, right? So this is the closed contour integral, and this is nothing but the dx I plus dy j. This is the dl vector in the xy plane. In the x direction, dl vector is dx into y. In the y direction, dl vector is dy into j. So this is nothing but f vector dot dl. so and the contour is closed, so we can simply apply the Stokes theorem. Stokes theorem always converts line integral into surface integral provided the condition that the contour must be closed. So here the contour is closed, so we can easily apply the Stokes theorem. So what we have to do, we have to find the curl of f vector here. So how to find the curl of f vector? Curl of f vector is nothing but the, we can find this curl of a vector by using the matrix method, that is ax, ay, az, or you can use ij, k cap, right? We can use both the things, that is ax vector, ay vector, and az vector. They are the unit vectors along the x, y, and z direction. Or we can also use I vector, j vector, and k cap vector, because in the question they are using x, y, they are using I, j, k vectors along the x, y, and j, x, y, and z direction, right? So this is nothing but del over del x, del over del y, del over del z. What is the value of x component? That is x. What is the value of y component? That is y. What is the value of z component? That is 0. So value of x component is x, value of y component is y, and the value of z component is 0. So we will solve this. What is the answer for this? That is I del y, kiske respect mein kar rahe hain, y ke respect mein kar rahe hain, kisko 0 ko differentiate kar rahe hain. So this is 0 minus del y over del z. So y will be treated as constant with respect to z. So this is the 0 minus j. अब j को, अब now we will solve for j. So this is del over del x, किसका करेंगे differentiation? 0 का. So this is 0, and also किस x को differentiate करेंगे with respect to z. So del x over del z will also 0 plus k. So we will solve this del y over del x minus del x over del y. So del y over del x will be also 0, and del x over del y will also 0. So this is 0 minus 0. So here all the terms are 0 here. So this is the answer. Curl of f is 0. What we are getting, that is curl of f vector will be 0 here. So the answer for this question by using the Stokes theorem is also 0. 0 dot df. This is nothing but the 0. So the answer for this question is 0, that is a part. And this answer is obtained by using two methods. First method is Green's method, and the second method is Stokes theorem. Both methods are easy. So by solving this question, we can easily get 1 mark in a few seconds. So this completes the solution. Hope you have understood the solution. And if you are the new to this channel, then please subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon to get the latest notification. Thank you.